For over 40 years, NOAA scientists have been collecting data and piecing together the story of the gray whale. Each year, new discoveries are made, revealing the secrets of this ancient traveler. With the northeastern Pacific population recovered, leading scientists from the NOAA Southwest Fisheries Science Center continue their research efforts to help save the western population from extinction. The most effective way to identify individuals and count the population is to photograph them from the surface. Using the gray whale's distinctive markings and gray spots caused by parasites on their skin, scientists document these characteristics to identify individuals.
So we're able to track migratory pathways and corridors by the simple use of photo identification. There are other ways to do that as well, biopsy sampling and genetics.
And from the air.
Aerial photography is one way you can study animals based on their size and shape. So you can learn a lot about nutritive and reproductive condition of whales just by measuring their size and shape from vertical aerial photographs.
You can also put satellite transmitters on them and track them remotely. You put the transmitter on and let them go, and you watch them move across the Pacific or down to China or wherever it might be.
To further learn and discover where these great sojourners swim, the team of researchers traveled to Russia and set up camp on Sakhalin Island.
The main focus of our research while we were on Sakhalin was to collect photo identification. If it was a whale that we had not collected a genetic sample from previously, we would also attempt to collect the sample from the whales.
Whereas whales are endowed with natural insulation, their human observers must gear up to brave the cold in order to study these marine giants up close.
We're typically only able to work about one-third of the time that we're there, and that's mostly due to this fog that just invades the area and sits sometimes for weeks on end. So it can be very challenging to try and do field work in this site.
Recently, two whales from the western population surprised scientists by migrating across the Pacific to the waters of California and Mexico.
It's a really fun finding. It's added another piece to the puzzle that we didn't previously know about. And I would have to say that it's opened up more questions than we had before.
Research scientists from Japan, Russia, and the United States share images of animals they've spotted.
We take a photograph of an individual off of Sakhalin Island, and we get a phone call from Japanese scientists, and they say, hey, guess what? We've got a picture of a gray whale in Japan. We say, can you send it to us? We'd love to try and match it. They'll send us the picture, we'll compare it to our catalog, and we'll say, hey, we've got a match from Sakhalin to Japan.
Unlike many species of whales that still remain on the endangered species list, the eastern Pacific gray whale, once on the brink of extinction, now numbers about 20,000 individuals. Recovery efforts that started 40 years ago and the ongoing research and monitoring by NOAA scientists have contributed to the conservation of the gray whales. Together, with legal protection and public education, scientists are playing their part to ensure the survival of this magnificent migratory animal.